Okay, it's 16 degrees and sunny, obviously. This is actually take two. I went on and on and on about something nobody wants to hear. So I decided to do it again, to scrap it and go and do it again. Anywho, it was completely cloudy. It was dark outside. It was so cloudy. And just because I'm sitting in my chair here with the blinds open, the sun decided to come out and blind out my TV and blind out me. So, you know, I just finished watching the last episode of season one of Star Trek, the original series. It's the one where Spock gets infected by the alien brain cell thing. Run amok or amok time or whatever the heck it was called is the episode, you know, where the colonists are all infected by the alien parasites, you know. And they want them to build ships so that they can go to other planets to infect, you know, that thing. Anyways, so I got, 50 more episodes to watch for the next two seasons in total. I think it's 50 episodes in total for the next two seasons. So that'll be a lot of watching. It'll take a little while longer. Anywho, we had a good coffee. I just had some lemon poppy seed cake, lemon poppy seed loaf. I had half the loaf, which means I'm going to die because it was sugar-free. artificial sweeteners aren't really good for the body, and they do a number on you. They give you diarrhea to be a little bit TMI. Yeah, that's exactly what they do to you. So I'm probably going to die now, but I didn't know it was sugar-free or I wouldn't have eaten so much of it. I just wouldn't have. I'm going to die. I was watching the TV, so I didn't really pay attention to the flavor not being right. And then when I realized it, I was already just about done. And I was on my last slice, and I'm like, you know, this tastes artificial. And I went and looked at the back, and sure enough, it's artificially sweetened. So I'm going to explode. Mm-hmm. Yippers. So anyways, if you have gone to my blog recently, my blog site, davenicholson.ca, you can see the puzzles that I've collected on Jigsaw's Galore. I posted a thing, a little graphic with the name of the folder and how many puzzles are in the folder and whatnot. There's a total of 3,018 puzzles in there. I also posted how to reset them all simultaneously if you don't want to go through hundreds of puzzles one at a time, right clicking them and hitting the reset thing to set them back to not being played yet condition. You can go to the folder. I've got the pathway written out there in the blog where you go to find the puzzle files. You navigate to the folder, you type in the search thing, JSS, and hit return. The save files are JSS, the puzzle files are JSM. You hit JSS in the search, and then you select all and you just delete them. And all the save files are gone now, and you can play all your puzzles over again if you want to. Instead of resetting them one at a time, which is very laborious and time-consuming. So, you know. Yeah, they used to have the previous version, version 6, instead of version 7 like I'm using, had a option of saving it as an executable file, which is basically a program that you run, runs by, you know, standalone program, basically. You don't need the Jigsaw's Galore to play the puzzle. It's got its own little engine to make the puzzle work. And you can't make puzzles with it or anything like that, and you can't play other puzzles. Each EXE is just one puzzle. that it has, and that's it. But used to use that to share with people that didn't have the program, and now you can't, with version 7, you can't share with people that don't have the program because there is no way of doing that. It only saves as the puzzle file, the JSM file. But you can share it to people that have the program by navigating to the folder and, of course, copying the file you want to send them and emailing it to them in a zip or something. So, or emailing a bunch of them in a zip or something. And of course, they have a system of sharing with people that have registered for the service, anyways, where you can email it to them through the app, and it will go to the website, and then send it through the website to other people that have the app that you're sending it to. You have to have their special email that is just for the service. Of course, you got to set up an email just for the service, and it's a bit of a pain in the ass that way. So if I rather than do that, I think I would rather just zip them, and I have in the past, just zip them and send them to people that I know have the program. So, Anyways, I'm getting sunlighted on here. It's getting brighter and brighter. It's the clouds have completely gone away now, so I'm going to and it's getting really quite warm in here because of it. So I'm going to close the blinds. I'm going to watch more Star Trek, and I'm going to turn my fan on. Y'all have a fabulous day and keep smiling.